It would be a leap of faith by Navy SEALs, the CIA, and President Obama that Osama bin Laden really was hiding at this million-dollar compound in Pakistan.
There was no one single piece of information that was an aha moment.
The final trail to getting bin Laden really started in 2003 when the CIA focused heavily on bin Laden's use of couriers to communicate.
You know, he's not communicating electronically, so he's got to meet face to face. That's much more difficult for us to track, but it's an opportunity. And they began at that point.
A U.S. official provided CNN with many details of the hunt. By 2005, they were looking for one man in particular, a courier who is a protege of Khalid Sheikh Mohammed, the chief planner of 9/11, and Abu Faraj al-Libi, a top bin Laden operative. Both men are under CIA interrogation. KSM refuses to talk about the courier. It's a clue how important he may be. In one government report posted by WikiLeaks, it notes the courier may have accompanied bin Laden in Tora Bora before the al-Qaeda leader disappeared in late 2001.
Our ability to monitor this individual who was the courier turned out to be the critical piece of information.
In 2007, the CIA learns the man's name, Abu Ahmed al-Kuwaiti, from what one official calls classic espionage. A U.S. official says Pakistanis provide some information, but the U.S. won't say what it was. By 2009, the CIA knows the general area in Pakistan where the courier is living. Once, they even spot him on the street. In August 2010, they learn the courier and his brother are living at this compound, but something isn't right. Why do they need 18-foot-tall walls, security gates, and a million-dollar mansion? By late 2010, the U.S. is covertly watching the compound around the clock. Overhead satellites keep an eye on it. Telephone conversations of the courier are intercepted. The courier and his brother are practicing extraordinary operational security. The official tells CNN they don't use their real name in the town. They burn their trash. Again, why? Who are they protecting? The U.S. comes to realize there's a third family there, and the family matches the makeup of Osama bin Laden's family. One of his wives, a son, and three children. But no sign of bin Laden. In September, the CIA briefs President Obama for the first time in depth. They tell the president they have found a really interesting compound and a courier with ties to Osama bin Laden. Now, just before President Obama authorized the attack on the compound, the CIA went back one last time, conducted an analysis, and said, could it be anything but bin Laden? The answer came back, we do think it's bin Laden who is there. But, Wolf, it wasn't until those Navy SEALs entered the room and saw him that anybody knew for sure.
Were there other options they gave the president before he authorized this raid?
By all accounts, yes. A U.S. official tells us the military actually began planning various options in February. One option, to bomb the site with U.S. aircraft. But that would have obliterated it and not much of a chance of having a body left to potentially show the world the face of the dead Osama bin Laden, if that's what the administration had decided it wanted to do. So that goes off the table. The other one was to do some kind of joint raid with the Pakistanis, but of course they were so concerned about the Pakistanis basically jeopardizing that mission, this is what they decided on.
Yeah, they thought the Pakistanis might tip off bin Laden about it and he could escape. Thanks, Barbara.